Hi, and good morning, guys. Quick look at the markets here. Oh, Bitcoin's going back up a little bit. Ethereum is still down. Ripple was doing good. I should have sold out while I could. Might get a little opportunity here. I had some steam and I sold it. I want to get some more when it goes back down, but I seen that jump, so I got out. Looks like it's gonna keep going up maybe. LTC, I sold a couple of these when I seen it was up. I've been selling them every day and then, you know, buying another, you know, 15, 20 of them. You know, nothing major, and then when it hits its highs, I'm not sure where exactly I sold this one. But I woke up this morning and sold down, so I probably bought it back in here somewhere. I wrote it down, but it's just a couple, it's not important. Ethereum, still waiting to get back up. I had a bunch here and somebody said to sell it, so I did, and then it went up even higher and I was mad that I sold, so I got back in, and then I should have sold up there. And I might have sold, but I, you know, I'm, for the most part, I'm still holding a couple of Ethereum. Just waiting for it to go back up. Just kind of trying to diversify a little bit. There's a couple ones that I like right now. There's more than that, but I've been selling. I sold some stuff to take out my loan yesterday. 48.86 for today so far is pretty nice. That's pretty cool to wake up and see that and not even have to do anything. That's pretty great. I think the coins are up a little bit. I still have I'm down to 45 in my wallet. I took out some to trade with and some to get that loan yesterday. I'm thinking about taking out some more. I do have about 10 that are about to start staking, so I'll show you what that's about as soon as that starts here. I'm pretty new to all of this. I just bought Bitcoin in March and started to see how great that was, and I got a little bit of Ethereum and Litecoin and seen that was, the Ethereum was doing even better, so I got into that and made some money. And then when it topped out, I got into this and like doubled my money, and I've been waiting for that to happen again. But I'm starting to think that that's not something that's, you know, that's rare. It's not something that happens all the time, so I'm sure it's gonna go up more. But at first I thought this was definitely where to be, just holding these coins and staking them. And you know, I was like, wow, that's even better than the lending. Why even do lending? But then I seen somebody do the calculations on if you compound, if you invest the compound interest. So basically taking this every day and reinvesting it. But I'm not gonna do that. I'm going to transfer that into coins because I want to take out a $1,000 loan at a time to get that extra 0.1%. I probably should have just scraped everything I had and got the 5,000, but I don't want to put everything into this just yet. I am going to get the 5,000 here. I'll be doing another $1,000 loan shortly within the next 20 days, because if I'm earning 50 a day on average, in 20 days I'll have another 1,000 just from the interest to put back into this. So that's the plan, is just for right now to really get that momentum going, get that snowball going and turn it into an avalanche, and then that way at that point pulling my 5 back out won't be a big deal. You know, I figured if I spread out, and really that's the best way to invest in any of these. You don't want to just go all in at a certain point. You want to spread out your buying to spread out your risk and also not have a bunch of regret and stress and be worried, was that the ultimate time to buy? Was I right? And if it wasn't, you can be like, oh, I'm so dumb. If it was, you know, you're gonna think you're so smart and then take more risks and get into more trouble. At least that's what I do. I think that's just human nature. Anyways, got off on a huge tangent there, talking about my strategy. I mean, it's relevant. We're talking about my crypto investment here. We're having a conversation in the focus group. Really like the focus group. I've seen the tree of how we're all related. Don't want to get into that. I don't want to get into our private conversation on there. I mentioned who sowed what, but it's pretty funny and it's very informative. I'm really learning a lot. They were talking about who the CEO of BitConnect is, and somebody said who the name was, and somebody else said how it's not really important, and I posted a link. Which link was it? Where? Let's go ahead and pull that up. Was it this one? Okay, here's where it says the guy, the CEO's name, I guess, and then here's. But like what they're saying in the group was it's not really important because it's on a blockchain, you know, and I'm kind of new to this, so at first I couldn't quite. It took me a minute to kind of think about it when they said the leaders aren't important. And the reason that is because like Bitcoin, it's on a blockchain and it's encrypted. You know, if it wasn't on the blockchain, it wouldn't be on here. So, even if like the site was to disappear, everybody would still have their wallets, their encrypted, secured, locked wallets. You know, you have to unlock it to stake, but it's still encrypted. It's got a password, passphrase. And even if the site were to go down, it's decentralized. So you could cut the head off the snake and two more would regrow, or at least one more would regrow. Somebody else would put it back up to continue business, you know, as usual. They got a great system. It's making tons of money, so there's no reason for it to go down in the first place. And second of all, even if it was to go down, it wouldn't matter because somebody else could just put up the site and, you know, everybody would still have their tokens. You know, maybe what was on the site you might lose, I don't know. You might be able to get those back, I don't know. But there'd be a record of it either way, because it's all, that's what the blockchain is. It's a ledger, and it keeps track of everywhere everything has been, and that's why it's so difficult to hack. The wallets can be hacked, though you gotta watch out. There was that Jax wallet with the security issue, but their wallet is, seems like it's one of the best ones that I've seen. I'm fairly new. I like this Exodus. I should probably just pull my money off of Poloniex and put it into here and just have like Bitcoin, Litecoin, and Ethereum. I'm a little nervous about this whole Bitcoin drama, but I don't think it's anything to worry about. But I'm mainly holding Ethereum right now. And I like Litecoin. But that's a great wallet. This is a great wallet. They also have phone apps. And I'm sorry to sound like a commercial for them. I'm just really excited. I mean, $48. I've looked into a lot of different ways of investing, like Genesis and cloud mining. And that one seems to be fairly legit. I've seen some other ones that weren't legit. I've seen some, you know, go down. But you know, you got to make sure it's on a blockchain. And let's see, kind of lost my train of thought there. What was I gonna say? It's early, guys. Let me drink some more coffee. 312 earned. Yeah, I think I was talking about how it almost sounded like a commercial, but it's just so exciting. Making this money every day. I was gonna see how Genesis seems like it's good too. I just got my 30-day payment with credit card from Genesis. I didn't know you had to wait 30 days, or I just would use Bitcoin. I'm new to this all though. I just got, you know, at the time when I found out about Genesis, I didn't have that many Bitcoin. So I seen you could use credit card, and you can only get so many through Coinbase at a time. And I was trading with the ones that I had, so I said just use the credit card. And I didn't know you had to wait 30 days. I got $20 for like 2 something in Genesis. I was gonna keep investing, but this just seems so much better. I might put some more in Genesis. I don't know for sure yet. Right now, I really just want to get this going. I want to get that momentum going. I don't want to put everything in here, but man, it's tempting to put another 1,000 in, make it a nice even 5. Make about $50 a day on average. And then every 20 days, you'd have another 1,000. Possibly. Maybe more. Oh, I was going to talk about these articles. That's where I went off of our conversation about how it's decentralized. And this was a good article here, I guess. I don't think I'm going to read it for you guys. I'll leave a link to this. It talks about, in less than 1 year, BitConnect's online community has gained over 50,000 around the world, added a news department, engaged with online leaders like Kim.com, successfully launched its own digital currency, added a Bitcoin wallet, and somebody said, why Kim.com? An innovative Bitcoin lending system. This might have been before the drama with them, but there's worse people that could be associated with. It's not that terrible, I don't think. Anyways, it surged from zero traffic to the top 80K Alexa ranking. Plenty of hard work and good times were had along the way, and it is a cool little community that I'm in here. That's all I'll say. Yeah, if you want to sign up with me and join my team, I could see if we can get you into that focus group. If not, we'll start our own focus group and kind of network together. But either way, this is a winning team, guys. I posted this link because I seen a video where they were saying this was the leader. And somebody in the focus group said that that might not be the leader, it's just probably somebody promoting it, like them, or me, or, I'm not really promoting it, I'm just saying what I'm doing. And, I'm making good money either way, I'm gonna keep putting money in it, so I don't really. Referrals are nice, if it happens, it happens, but I don't have any referrals right now, and I'm not really worried about it. I'm still gonna make videos, especially once I get this going, and I. And quit talking about it for a minute. I have big plans for my channel. I'm going to, I don't want to get into it all now, but I'm going to be going through several other different ways of making money online. And we're going to kind of use our BitConnect earnings as seed money, as passive income, to then put into other ways of making money. Trading is one of those ways. I'm gonna keep doing trading videos if I keep trading. I got a lot of things I'm looking at. I always do a lot of research. I researched this for a week. It was the 23rd when I signed up with BitConnect, and it took me a whole week. And I know that because I bothered my girlfriend so much, talking to her about it every day, that she marked it down in her little diary. So that's how I know. So I started talking about it, and I quit. I don't bother with that anymore. Try not to, because she listens to me, but she probably doesn't really understand all these different coins and stuff. She'll probably get into it one day, but she's working every day and has got her own life and stuff. And I've always been more into computers, and I've heard about Bitcoin for years, and I've been wanting to get in for a long time. Coinbase really made it easy to just sign up and put your credit card in and just start buying them. I'll leave a code if you want to sign up with Coinbase. That's what I'd recommend you do if you're new. Just get on there, get into the, look into putting up a wallet to hold your bitcoins in that you buy, and then just watch the price go up on that. Buy a few things with it maybe and see how it works, and then. Look into some others in the top, but the better ones like Ethereum, Litecoin. You pretty much can't go wrong with probably anything in this top 10. I've seen do really well, and even if it does go down in a couple of days, it'll eventually go back up. So Yeah, that's a good way to just get started. I'll leave my link down to Coinbase. If you sign up with it, you get $10. I get $10 for free. And then think about BitConnect if you want to. Don't go jumping into it just because I said to. Watch what I did. Like I said, it took me a week thinking about it, watching videos, reading everything I could find about it. And yeah, it's supposed to be a BitConnect team here. They're in Jakarta. But like somebody was saying, don't even worry about who the leaders are. It's more about the decentralized community is what makes it great. And I'll do more videos explaining that better as I understand it better. But you know, basically, it's the blockchain's ledger keeps track of where everything's supposed to be. It makes the network secure so that somebody can't just, you know, steal all the Bitcoin or whatever because it's encrypted. And they would have to hack multiple computers, is my understanding, like simultaneously. And that's not gonna happen. So, how long has this been? 16 minutes. I'm gonna try to keep my videos around 15. I'll do some more here. I want to talk about some of my other plans, but I don't want to get into it yet, just in case things change. But I have things working on. I'm setting up like a studio, and like I said, some other ways for you guys to make money. And I'm gonna keep looking into those ways, and I'm gonna keep showing you how I'm doing with the BitConnect, what I'm making. I'm gonna go ahead and transfer this into some of the coins because it looks like the coins are starting to go up a little bit. So we're just gonna hit transfer all $48. We're gonna go ahead and transfer that, and that's gonna bring me up to 5 1/4 coins about. And we'll just keep stacking those up until we can do another $1,000 loan. And I'll keep letting you know how this volatility software works and how it's paying out. If you want to sign up for notifications, there's big things going to be coming to this channel. This isn't just a BitConnect promotion channel. BitConnect's just allowed me to not worry about making money all day long. You know, trying to find work and stuff. I'm gonna have some good passive income coming through, and then I could pursue things, other ways to make money and still have money coming in no matter, you know, what happens with my other avenues. Yeah, so they also have these calculators where you can calculate just real quick on like let's say you do a $100 loan for. What is it? Is it 300 days? 299, I think, is for 100 days. So, if you calculate that out, this wasn't working out for me. That's why I didn't do this quicker. But it's working now. You would make 300, and then you would get your principal back. Oh wait, did I do that wrong? I'm sorry. I just started using this thing. Term length. I was doing it in a calculator. So your principal is how much you put in. So if you put in $100 for a term length of 299, which is how long $100 is, $1,000 is only 239 days, 5,000 to 10,000 is 179, 10,000 is 120 days. So, and this is at one time. It doesn't build up. So if you want this for the $1,000, you have to do a $1,000 loan. But if you want to just do 100 to see how that works. You would make, according to this. Oh crap, where did that go? I've got so many open. Oh, it was right there. Yeah, $100 at the normal interest. This is a 30-day average. I think it was a little more yesterday. Or no, if you do 1,000, I think it goes up a little bit. But anyways, $100. Calculate. That would be 299% return ROI. You'd make 399, and then get your 100 back. I think. profit with principal. Okay, so that's with your $100 back. You'd make $400. So you make 300, get your 100 back. But if you kept putting that in every day, every time you got $10 up, you reinvested it, I think it works out to like 1300. Don't quote me on that, but I've seen somebody else and it was somewhere around 1300, I believe, with compound interest. So that's what I'm looking to do. And I think if I can get 5 in there by July, and then I calculated with just a calculator, if I waited to the end of the month and reinvested, you know, I did that to make it easy. I think it works out to like, it was at least 20K, if not 30K. So yeah, let's wrap this video up. I was gonna say, if you wanna turn your notifications on every day, I'm gonna try to make these videos quicker, just quick updates. This is what I made today. This is what I got total. So, you know, just a quick recap. In summary, I made 4,000 today. I'm sorry, I have 4,000 as of today with my 1290 loan yesterday, and I misspoke yesterday. So now I have 4,000. I've earned 312. If we go to transactions real fast, from the lending wallet, see what I made, $21 off of the 1200. So I haven't even got that 1290 payment yet. Maybe I'll do an update tonight when I get that, but it's probably gonna be more than 21, because that one was 1290. This is 1200, so I got another $20 coming today. So this is great. It's gonna be hard not to do with another 1,000 here real soon. So subscribe, and I'm also gonna have more ways of making money. So like if you like that idea, dislike if you thought this was terrible. Can't really blame you. Alright, I'll talk to you guys later. Have a good one. Peace.